YouTube, we have to have a serious conversation. You just put out a tweet saying the reason that Ackman's whole entire channel was demonetized, he was removed from the partnership program, was because he put out a tweet threatening to dox YouTube employees, all right? And that you take the safety of YouTube employees very serious, all right? There's a lot of issues with this. One, Ackman's tweet was a joke, all right? And to explain the joke, it's very simple. You know, he was doxed by Quantum TV. He went to YouTube and said, I'm being doxed by this guy. There's a recording of the doxing. He's literally calling Ackman TV's mom and no action was taken. So he's making a joke on Twitter that doxing is okay. It is a joke. It's everybody knows it's a joke. Me and Jake Lucky, esport reporter, never agree on anything. We're in agreement on this, that it was clearly a joke. But if you're going to have the position that you take the safety of YouTube employees serious, where you have to take action, then I have to bring up Ethan Klein doing a call for action on YouTube to bomb the NRA building. Because I know for a fact there were YouTube employees in the NRA building. Now, how does this compare? All right. Someone making a joke about a dox and then someone doing a call to action to a terrorist attack on US soil where YouTube employees are actually in the building. He got a strike. Ethan Klein got a strike on that video. Just a strike, okay? But Ackman TV's entire channel is demonetized. Do you really care about YouTube employees' safety? Bigger question, do you care about our safety as creators? Because I know so many creators that went to YouTube saying, look, this is happening, that's happening, I'm being harassed, I'm being doxxed, and no action gets taken. And this Ackman story, all right? No action was taken on Quantum TV yet, but you took action on Ackman first? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense.
A cycle of nightmares, and they don't fight fair, but I'll be right here, hands up high with my parry arm up, till I carry on up these dreams out the box, up the right stairs, and I've been fighting for a minute, a long list of givens that we chisel, even if they cause schisms, or a crack or a break in the mold we make, pay tribute to the motherfucking tolls we paid. I'm gone till November, a long list of members that we missed on the list, apologize for December, the long winter fell on this Game of Thrones, but I'll be living out the box till I'm HBO. We all fall, we all rise, we all ride. With the bumps and bruises proven to them, we all try to do something with the gift, something to uplift. Eating chicken noodles, soup until my soul gets fit. The biggest loser in the world, or the Duke of fucking Earl. Both poles representing while we looking for our pearls. The we, the us, and all beings who are sick of being cynical and trying to find a meaning to this life that we cooked up. Then we shook up. Recipe we.
Oh, Jesus H. Christ, Mary, Joseph, what the fuck is going on? Excuse me, but what the fuck, YouTube? Like, listen, I know how shitty this platform can be, and honestly, it can be a real shithead. It can be like Twitch, if not worse than Twitch at times. Hell, it can be as bad as Facebook, if not worse than Facebook. And currently, they're being worse than Facebook and Twitch, which is saying something. How can you fuck up this badly? Like, Jesus Christ. Okay, so, for those of you living under a fucking rock, let me tell you, this Ackman Quantum TV bullshit should have never gone to this length. It shouldn't have. At all. Quantum TV should be off of YouTube. Ackman should still be monetized. Case closed. End of story. There was way too much evidence against Quantum TV, and I don't care if they freaking hit me with anything. It's a fact that they had way too much evidence against Quantum TV for him to go scot-free. But what happens? Because of a fucking joke. A fucking joke of a tweet. Which, here's the big kicker. Here's the big kicker. YouTube themselves said, oh, they can't go back on deleted tweets against Quantum TV, which is bullshit, because they went and decided to demonetize Actman off of a deleted fucking tweet. What the fuck? Like, honestly, this is not okay. This is straight up not okay. This is absolutely bullshit. This should have never fucking happened. And I don't care what happens to my channel. I'm not fucking big enough for this shit. But I don't give a shit. This is fucking retarded. Straight up retarded. This is like the mental mind game of a fucking 2-year-old child. Like, how can you fuck up this badly? You have during... Let me rephrase this. It's Pride Month, by the way. Pride Month. And you let a homophobe walk on your platform scot-free. But you have a guy being the Axe Man who gets demonetized for doing absolutely nothing but doing one fucking joke. Like, are you... How brain dead are you? Like, I agree with Keemstar completely on this situation. Like, holy fuck. Listen. I know Keemstar gets a lot of shit and a lot of shit. He gets an absolute lot of shit. Which sometimes is justified. I agree with sometimes it's justified. Sometimes it's not. All right. He acts like, you know, a scummy journalist a lot of the times, trying to get information out of you, no matter how much it hurts. But just that's just the way Keemstar is. All right. But I do agree with him on this. How can you do this to the Axeman when Ethan Klein decided to fucking... I have the video. I have the clip. I have the clip he posted on his Twitter. I'm pretty sure I'll put this in the beginning of the video. But Ethan Klein straight up threatened to bomb the NRA, the NSA, whatever. And you give him a strike. But yet, the Axeman gets demonetized off of doxing. Which was a joke. It was satire. You can tell it was a fucking joke. Like, I don't understand. I fucking don't understand, dude. They're fucking... YouTube is absolutely brain dead. Like, there's a lot of... I'm sure there's a lot of people at YouTube who are just, you know, they're cool, they're chill, they're fine. But for the ones in the suits who decided to fucking demonetize the Actman because of this shit, because of a fucking childish move of Quantum TV being a bullshitter, which that's all Quantum TV is. He's a bullshitter. He's a liar. He's a fucking scumbag. Like, he's a fucking scumbag. End of story. He's a fucking scumbag. But, like, I don't get why the Axeman gets demonetized when you have freaking... You had Ethan Klein on your fucking... platform for so long, and he's also a shit person. And then, oh, let's not forget, you invite EDP back on your fucking platform, and he's still here. How can you, as a fucking platform, allow a pedophile, and I will say it, a pedophile on your fucking platform, and you have, who's the Actman, who's a absolute chill dude, and has done absolutely nothing wrong to your fucking platform, makes you how much money compared to Quantum and EDP, and you're telling me you take their side over the Axeman. What the fuck is wrong with this goddamn platform? Like, I'm sure there's people at YouTube who hate the higher-ups, and this is why we need a new CEO of YouTube, because this is fucking ridiculous. And they're silencing other YouTubers who are, like, popular. Like, I'm sure Angry Joe's gonna do a video, possibly a video, and... He's talking to people. He even said on his Twitter, he's talking to people. He's talking to his own rep from YouTube, trying to sort this thing out, which I hope it does get sorted out. I hope Actman does get his monetization back, which it shouldn't have been demonetized anyway. He shouldn't have. There was no reason to. Like, Absolutely fucking none. And oh, fucking Christ. Ugh, Jesus. Oh, this is going to be the fucking 20-minute rant, and I know it. This editing is going to be, oof. Because I am going to have videos mixed in with my video. And listen, Actman doesn't deserve this. You know who does deserve to be deplatformed and demonetized? Quantum deserves it. Ethan Klein deserves it. EDP deserves it. EDP shouldn't even be on here because he was banned the first time. He's ban evading too. That's two YouTubers who are ban evading. You know what? Alex Jones, come on back. I agree with this. Alex Jones, you need to come back to YouTube then. If EDP, who is a pedophile, is ban evading, then come on back. Honestly. You're safe to come back, Alex Jones. I mean, the heads of this platform, it's so outrageously bad. Like, Jesus fuck. Good God. Fuck. Oh, God. Dude, this is insane. This is absolutely fucking insane. I don't have any words for it. I really don't. Fertenga did a video on it yesterday. Alex did a video on it today. Alex did a stream on it with Fertenga yesterday. Like, Griffin streamed yesterday about it. Review Tech did a video on it the last 2 days. Am I missing anyone else? Everyone's done videos on this shit. And I bet you every single one is demonetized. I bet you every single one's demonetized because of this bullshit. Like, how? Jesus fucking Christ. Oh, Lord, give me the strength. Ugh. So, while I'm here ranting, I'm going through Twitter, and I'm going through Actman's Twitter. I'm going through Keemstar's Twitter. I'm going through a lot of people's Twitter. Yep. Keemstar has a video as of 6 hours ago. That's another one. Let's see. Like I said on, yep, John Alert, YouTube made itself look bad. Yeah, it did. It did. Oh, and let's not forget the quartering. Let's not forget the quartering. Because he did a video on it. He also got swatted yesterday, which, listen, it's not cool to swat other creators. It's not. It's such a dick move. Why do you have to swat people? Because you hate them. Who cares? Who cares if you don't like someone? They don't deserve to get swatted. Especially him and, what was the other guy, Tim Pool, I believe his name is. Like, you have Axeman's YouTube bullshit, and then you have Quartering getting fucking swatted. Like, this world is fucking insane. It's literally ran by fucking retards. Like, this platform is run by retards. This country is run by retards. A lot of this shit, people getting swatted, people swatting in general are a bunch of retards. So, yeah, I just, dude, this is fucking insane. Like, these last 3 days have shown me how shit fucking YouTube can be and how fast you get demonetized. Like, Jesus Christ, it's fucking Pride Month. You let a homophobe go. You let a pedophile run on your platform as well. And then you just, Leafy's gone because I don't really know the full Leafy story. I didn't really pay attention to it at the time. Then you let Alex Jones go because he is crazy. But to me, the good kind of crazy. So yeah, this is insane. This is absolutely fucking insane. But I hope you guys enjoyed. And Quantum's probably in his Discord talking mad shit right now. We have spies in Discord, on his Discord, so we know what he says. And honestly, none of it's pretty. I know they mass flagged the Act Man. They completely mass flagged the Act Man. Honestly, if Act Man gets demonetized, Quantum should get demonetized too. He should. So, alright, that's it for me. I'll see you guys in the next video. Enjoy the clips.